5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back, Cathedral. I'm very excited, and welcome to the 10th anniversary of Cathedral Catholic High School. We're excited at this campus and particularly the new opportunities. We obviously have a new schedule, which brings a lot of change, but we're excited because the new schedule has also brought us new opportunities with classes. Many of you have some really exciting elective opportunities this year. We've massively expanded our visual performing arts department, but every department has something new to offer, and we're really using these classes to give every student to find new talents and gifts that God's given them and to develop them. We're also excited. We have a great faculty here, and we're blessed with many new faculty to the school. These are teachers who are gifted and talented, and really the whole 100 teachers and counselors offer you just a great support system, new opportunities to learn, but also just that love and affirmation of who you are and what you can do great this year. So I wish you all a great year. I'm very excited to have you here. Happy 10th anniversary, and to CCTV, we're excited for a great year for you as well.
I decided to take my talent here because when I came onto campus for the interview, I could feel that it was a great place of community and faith.
I like the way that's phrased. It makes me sound like LeBron. My wife and I moved here to be closer to family. Her family lives here.
And I decided to bring my talents here because I heard great things about the school, and also I'm very excited about the technology and how it's being used here.
I love Cathedral Catholic. I love the dawns of Cathedral.
It's a lot different. I spent time at both schools as a student, and now here as a teacher, and it was a different atmosphere at uni, but we've brought the atmosphere to this school as well.
I came from Arizona, a small town called Sierra Vista, and I taught biology and active physics at Tombstone High School.
Why I decided to come here is I wanted to move back to San Diego, and when I started applying around, I saw an opening at Cathedral.
This is my first year teaching in a classroom. Before this, I did special events, and so I was all over San Diego and in Northern California.
I love Cathedral. It was a little weird for me because I'm actually a graduate of Our Lady of Peace.
Before Cathedral, I was at Gonzaga College High School, an all-boys prep school in Washington, D.C., and then I moved here a year ago to open a gym with my friend.
Before Cathedral, I was the youth minister at Ascension Catholic Church in Tierra Santa.
The reason that I chose to work at Cathedral is because many years ago, I went to uni and had a wonderful time.
Well, I have been here for the last 5 years as a substitute counselor, and I've worked for all the other counselors, and so this is my first year as a full-time counselor.
Just outside of Portland, Oregon. Teaching, and moved down to Cathedral because my wife's from here and she really wanted to move back to San Diego, and so I applied to jobs and found this one.
I was at Torrey Pines High School working part-time, and I really wanted a full-time position.
My spirit animal is definitely a kitten.
A taco would win in a fight over a grilled cheese sandwich any day. It's got more nutritious in it, more vegetables, and a lot of more of the basic food groups in it as well.
Grilled cheese tacos are flimsy. They'll last for a while, but then they'll lose their form. Especially the crunchy shells, they'll just break.
If I could be any ice cream flavor, I would be coffee ice cream. Love coffee.
I'd probably have to go with Captain America because I am a military wife. Go USA.
the cat sail, where the cat tries to jump and completely fails and misses. Oh, and there's also one called cat fan, where the cat tries to get something on a fan and then spins around and around and around in circles and then hits the wall.
The video of my cats when they were kittens, it has maybe over a million hits.
Whoa. Probably Lucy, because she's kind of bossy, and so am I.
I think I'd like to be Mr. Ray from Finding Nemo, because he's a science teacher.
Just one too many. If I had one more, we would have been in the World Cup finals.
Good morning, Dons, and welcome back to CCTV. I'm Aiden McKay.
And I'm Kara Stevick. We hope you've been having a wonderful week.
For now, let's head off to our top story with Emily on the Senior Overnighter.
Seniors, our annual Senior Overnighter is coming up in a couple weeks, so I caught up with a few of the moderators and some of our students to tell us more about it.
Hi, seniors. It's your two senior class moderators, Ms. Padgett and Mr. Filipponi, and we want to tell you about the Senior Overnighter, which is coming up on Saturday, September 27th. Please arrive at school at 7:30 p.m. so we can get you checked in, and Mr. Filipponi is going to tell you what you should and should not bring.
What you should bring is yourself. What you shouldn't bring is ice chests, tents, air mattresses, furniture, inflatable furniture, folding chairs, chaise lounges, barbecues of any time, gas or electric, that includes George Foreman grills, waffle makers, or other cooking devices allowed.
So the Senior Overnighter is in about a week or so, and on ASB, the senior class officers have been preparing for the last couple weeks, just preparing posters and making sure everything's in check. There's going to be a DJ, we're going to watch some movies, a lot of fun things are planned.
We have a dance floor set up, some snacks and drinks, so get excited, come ready for a fun night with your class, and hashtag team no sleep is the trend we're going for, so we hope to see you there.
Also, please do not bring any animals.
It's also really important that you don't bring any liquids, but please bring all the food that you could possibly want to eat for the entire night. Bring a pillow, a sleeping bag, and it's going to be a great time. It's a great way for you to bond with your other 2015 classmates. So if you have any questions, or if you've yet to turn in your form, come get one of these green forms from one of us and turn it in by Wednesday, September 24th, and we'll see you at the Senior Overnighter.
I hope to see everyone from the class of 2015 at the Senior Overnighter on September 27th. I'm Emily. Have a great weekend, Dons.
Thanks, Emily. We can't wait for next Saturday.
In the meantime, those interested in participating in band and orchestra are welcome to come and try out some instruments today during lunch or even after school.
Next Friday, a grade update will be sent to all students, and the senior stretch photo will also be taken.
The sophomore movie night will also take place next Friday, so we hope to see you all there.
For now, let's catch up with our field reporters on more information for next week's Club Week and Freshman Retreat.
Club Week is next Tuesday through Friday. It'll be at lunch on the Knoll.
And we have a variety of different clubs, ranging from like service clubs like Key Club to even like the Don's Frisbee Club. So the Cathedral students can get exposure to a ton of new and exciting clubs.
So what day is Freshman Retreat?
For the first half of the alphabet, it's going to be September
24th and September
25th.
And also, what should the freshmen be looking forward to?
Freshmen should come with a positive attitude and they should come in spirit dress.
Also, please do not bring any cell phones, pagers, or iPads. This is a very non-electronic zone. We're trying to go against the grain. And also, don't bring a lunch. We will provide that. Also, snacks. You will be well fed, so don't worry about that.
Thanks, guys. We can't wait for next week.
In other news, if you are either a senior or a junior, be sure to sign up for college visits.
For those interested in criminal justice, there will be an informational meeting for the CCHS mock trial team today at lunch. Please see the bulletin for more information.
Well, Dons, it's that time again. Let's catch up with Michaela for some sports.
Good morning, Dons. My name is Michaela Day, and I'm your new 2014-2015 CCTV sports anchor. And let's get right to it. Your Dons football team beat the Torrey Pines Falcons last Friday, 8-7. In the fourth quarter, the team scored a safety thanks to the Falcons' botched snap. And senior Tim Semenza scored two field goals. Let's send it off to the football field where I caught up with some of the football players after their win. All right, congrats on the win. How do you feel?
Oh my God, I mean, honestly, I just feel elated. It was a crazy game.
I feel so good.
We feel great, and it, you know, it was a team win and everything like that, and we guys, we had studs like this on our team, and there's not much you can say being a team like this and at a time like that. I mean, shouts out to Tim Semenza. I mean, that was a big come through.
Exactly. And Ray, how do you, what's been the motivating factor for you for this win?
Well, I have never lost a Tory my 4 years at Cathedral, and I didn't plan on losing again.
Well, there you go. Thanks, guys.
Come out and support your Dons football team tonight at 7 as they face Helix. Your Lady Dons volleyball team has won against University City and Santa Fe Christian recently, but lost to the Torrey Pines Falcons last Friday. They compete in a tournament in Las Vegas this weekend. Your Lady Dons tennis team is on the road towards a great season with recent wins against Valhalla and La Jolla Country Day. They also won against Fallbrook in the Titan Doubles Invitational. The boys and girls cross-country teams compete in the Mount Carmel Invitational tomorrow. And the girls' golf team kicked off their season with some wins against Carlsbad and OLP. Lastly, your girls' field hockey team plays in the Sarah tournament this weekend. They've already won against Bishops and Poway, so good luck to them and all of our teams in their games and competitions. I'm Michaela Day, back to you in the Anchor Room.
Thanks, Michaela, and good luck to all those competing this week.
Make sure you go out and support the Dons tonight when they take on Helix.
Well, Dons, that's all the time we have this week. My name's Aiden McKay.
And I'm Kara Stevick.
Have a great weekend, Dons.